Welcome to Biology Made Easy. We are still discussing mitosis and meiosis series. Specifically, we are going to look at chromosome numbers, homologous chromosomes, karyotype, diploid, haploid alleles. Welcome. Well, I have this individual here. It's a male. It has cells. The whole body is made up of cells. And the cells that make up the body are body or somatic cells. Each cell has 46 chromosomes. I have one type of body cell here, is reproductive mother cell. It's also a body cell in the testis, and it also have 46 chromosomes. So all the cells of the body of this male father, female mother, each one has 46 chromosomes. Now, these body cells, they divide by mitosis to produce more body cells for growth and also for repair of tissues. Now, this body cell, reproductive mother cell, found in the testis of a male, it divides by meiosis and it produces sex cells, sperms. And the sperm has 23 chromosomes. Come to the female, the body cell, reproductive mother cell, has also 46 chromosomes. It divides by meiosis and produces 23 chromosomes. Now, the number of chromosomes in the body cells or somatic cells of the male and female, which is 46, is what gives the chromosome number of the species called Homo sapiens man. So chromosome numbers is the number of chromosome in an organism. It's a characteristic feature of the organism. Humans have 46 chromosomes in each body cell. Gorilla, 48. Others like Drosophila has only 8. That is chromosome number. So here are all the chromosomes I have drawn here. If we count all of them, you have 46. Now, these chromosomes, 46, if you look here, 46, this person has sperm, this has an egg, 23 chromosomes from the male, 23 chromosomes from the female, form a zygote that will form an individual. So this individual with 46 chromosomes, 23 of these chromosomes came from mother. So 23 chromosomes are maternal and 23 of these chromosomes are paternal from father. Good. Now, if we look at all these 46 chromosomes, you can look at this chromosome I have labeled one here. It's quite similar to this one. Then we have this one, which looks similar to this one. So this one must have come from father, this from mother. You look at this chromosome, it's quite similar to this one. So this one must have come from father, this one from mother. So all the 46 chromosomes, half of it is maternal from mother, half of it is paternal. Father. This brings us to the definition of homologous chromosomes. So homologous chromosomes are pairs of chromosomes normally of the same size and shape, that's the physical appearance. They bear the same numbers and types of genes. One is maternal, the other one is paternal. So here, this chromosome and this chromosome are homologous, one paternal, one maternal. This and this are also homologous. They bear the same gene. So if paternal gene A, maternal with gene A. This one, if gene A is for tongue rolling, this one can roll tongue, this one can't roll tongue. B here is sickle cell. You have this sickle cell gene is here. Another cell is here for sickle. So similar genes on the same locus. Now the chromosomes, as we have seen well as cell division, each of them can be cut. And when it's cut, the homologous chromosomes will be put together like this I have tried to do. The chromosomes are arranged in sets in numerical order and in homologous pairs. So this and that is one here. It looks very similar to another one, which we label 2, 3, etc. So this arrangement where the chromosomes are arranged in sets in numerical order is the karyotype. So this is the karyotype, but the photograph is karyogram. So as we said, karyotype is set of chromosomes arranged in numerical order and in homologous pairs. And then you see the karyogram neatly. Well, the karyotype or the karyogram, if there's a faulty chromosome, that one could be found out so that the chromosome numbers can be seen and any faulty one can be found out. Now let's talk about diploid. It's simply a cell or organism that have two copies of each chromosome or gene. So we come here, the body cells are diploid. They have 46 chromosomes. So we'll say that the body cell is 2N. It has two copies of chromosomes. One is from mother and one from father, diploid. Then you come to haploid cell, is this one. This is haploid. This one is also 2N, and this is haploid. Haploid have the half number of chromosomes that is in a body cell. So what happens if the organism has three copies of the same chromosome? So we have an organism here. This organism is diploid. If it's diploid, it has two copies of the same chromosome or gene. The same chromosome because it carries the same gene, maternal, paternal. Triploid, it has three copies of the same chromosome. Tetraploid has four copies of the same chromosome. We now want to look at the term locus. Locus is just the position of a gene on a chromosome. So I have gene A here on the other paternal chromosome. I have gene A here, and the position where the genes are is the loci. So this is the locus, this is the locus for this locus. So locus is just simply the position of a gene on a chromosome, and the locus of a gene never changes. The gene is at the same locus on the same chromosome. Now, allele. Alleles are different forms of the same gene. So I have gene big A, gene small a. They are all genes for color, different forms of the same gene occupying the same locus. This is the locus, the position, this is the locus. So occupying the same locus on homologous chromosomes. And as we said, different forms of the same gene produce contrasting characters. That's allele. So gene A, big A, and gene small a are allele. So I say gene for color is big A, and in genetics, genes are represented by letters. So the gene for color, you can have red color, which is big A, white color, small a, yellow color, small a, this asterisk. But the characteristics is produced not by just one gene anyway, but this is to simplify it and discuss what alleles are. So I have this homologous pair here. This locus has A asterisk. This locus has A. This A asterisk produces yellow color. This one produces white color. So this gene and this gene are alleles, different forms of the same gene occupying the same locus on homologous chromosomes producing contrasting characteristics. That is allele or allele. Well, this brings us to the end of our journey through the discussion of these terms. If we've been useful, please give us your thumbs and please subscribe. Thank you very much. Goodbye.